let me tell you first that you are the most adored and loved even by the God. Why? I'll give the answer also. When the world was created, it was neither the small children nor the old ones. Had it been, who would have taken care of the young ones, children? Who was there to take care of them? Had there been a creation of older people, they would not have reproduced. So God created only youth. And it's not the story of Adam and Eve, just one, two persons, hundreds of youth were created. Because God was knowing that this world can be taken over only by the youth. So you are all very lucky to be in this phase of life. We must celebrate it, and we must create something. We must create an impact in the society so that people could remember us. Today, when we talk about India, we think it is the best of the time or the worst of the times. It is the best of the times. Our youth, they have created name wherever they went, not only in India, in abroad, almost in every field. Even otherwise also, almost 82% of the inventions and discoveries, they were done by the youth people. On the other hand, what is happening on the roads? You must have read in the today's paper, yesterday's paper, police has caught 5,000 youth on motorbikes. Breaking the law is mardanagi. They know the law, but they want to break it. They want to violate. Especially in the western suburbs and the Marine Drive, you might see between 12 to 3 in the night, many will they come? Do so many stunts. That is also mardanagi, youth. Drug consumption is going up. Now there is a very burning topic of Mumbai city now about the nightlife. Why dance bars is not being allowed? Who wants to enjoy these dance bars? Where there is dance, there is alcohol, there is everything, drugs, all these things, rave parties. Why law is controlling them? It is a free world. And who are the freedom most? It is the youth. But freedom to which extent? We must enjoy. That is our birthright. But not the expense of our health. Not at the cost of your life. Not at the cost of your name, of your family. Not at the cost of violation of the law. We must enjoy. There should be a limit to it. We must all earn money. There is nothing wrong about it. Earning money, minting money is nothing wrong. You all know about Lakshmi. Lakshmi stays with whom? Vishnu. Vishnu the god. It means there is nothing wrong in earning money. But what is happening? There is a rat race for earning money. It's not through honest means, but dubious means. That is why crime in the society is going up. So much of materialistic feelings are there. So much of disparity is there. You talk about Mumbai city. So much of disparity. Almost 50% of the population lives in slums. In India, we have the best of institutions. And thousands of youth, they are going abroad. Might be UK, Australia, and US for studies. You know, only 12% youth get admission to the higher college institute. Only 12% of India. 12.4, if I remember correctly. Almost 88%, more than 80% youth, they do not have the college to go. Millions of people are starving. Don't say that we are a poor country. No, we are not poor. It's a very rich country, but with poor people. Something is wrong somewhere. Something seriously we are missing. What for education is there? Education means real freedom. Real freedom. Freedom from the difficulties. Freedom from all kinds of the problems in life. If you have that kind of the education, you are really educated. If you are getting sick, are you educated? If a doctor is getting sick, whether doctor is really doctor? We have to think about these things. I don't want to address the doctors here. But I'm telling you, jokingly I'm telling, seriously I'm telling you, most of our doctors are falling sick. Why? Think about it. Why our engineers, doctors, architects committing suicides? Mumbai city, we have around, every year, we have around 250 murders in a year. Suicides are around 1400. Around 6 times more. Young people, so-called educated people are committing suicide. Why they are committing suicide? It means we have not understood the real significance of this human life. If you cannot do anything, you achieve anything while you are alive, can you get something after your death? Just simple fact. But somebody has to ingrain this fact into the life, into the minds of the youth people, young people. The most precious life on earth. We claim to be the most intellectual among all the beings, living beings on earth. Have you ever heard any dog, just I'm giving very, very simple, layman's example. Any dog, there is a time, na? What is that? जब मैं बोलना शुरू करता हूँ बोलता रहता हूँ. Have you seen any dog? He has become old, but he cannot run. Have you seen? You won't find any dog. He is last phase in his life, but even then he is keep on running. Have you seen any animal who can't see properly, who requires spec? कान खराब हो गए मशीन लगाना पड़ता है. Have you seen? Heart attack, eyes, ears, all kinds of the problems are with human being, with the so-called intellectuals, most intellectual. Why? Something terribly is missing for our system. We all know that this body is made up of the 5 basic elements. I don't know how many youth of today know about it. If you want to remain healthy, you must know about it. If you want to go up in the life, you must know what education means. Education does not mean only the bookish knowledge. It does not mean. Vice Chancellor Sahab aage abhi aapko batayenge. His basic complaint is, how can a police commissioner speak about education? Only 1 minute left. Okay, no problem. That is why I was telling these fellows, organizers, I require more time to speak to youth. In Mumbai city, in all the colleges, we have this set up this Mrutyunjay clubs, Mission Mrutyunjay. How to overcome this untimely death? Which is created by the act of terrorism or the crime. How to be a responsible citizen, how to be a responsible youth. Because the future of a nation is created in our classrooms. Classroom does not mean only in educational institutions. Our classroom starts in our homes. In the lab of our mothers, in the classrooms. Only thing, just I think my time is off, I think. Okay, you can ask me any questions. Yeah, please.
Check. Yeah, one second.
Good evening, sir. I'm sure today's youth would be very curious to know that when you were young, you know, how did
still
you...
Still I'm young.
I'm sure. So when you were not so young,
yes.
How did you enjoy your life and show your mardangi?
Still every day, whenever I see the opportunity, I show my mardangi. Yes, please.
Yeah. I'll give you a mic.
As Pune commissioner, before you've seen Pune, and now you're seeing Bombay, how different is the youth there, knowing that that is where the most amount of students are actually compared to this? How different is the youth there or here in today's world?
See, I have been the police commissioner of Nagpur city, Pune city. I call Nagpur the central capital of India. Pune is the cultural capital of India. And Mumbai, you all know, the financial capital of India. There is a difference. But the difference between Pune and Mumbai, what you are telling, is slowly and steadily is going away. But still, today somebody was telling me that in Mumbai, cyclists and motorcyclists or the pedestrians, they think that they are the owners of the road. Pune is still there is something. Since the culture is still is there with them, they believe in the culture, and most of them, I will not call all of them, but they believe, yes, we should not violate the law. But Mumbai is basically a typical business culture. You will feel many people, you will laugh also on this. About a month back, one inspector came to me, my police officer, traffic inspector. He was telling me, very, very shyly he was telling me, sir, wo do mahine pehle wo madam udhar aayi thi, udhar kidhar aayi thi? He was talking about my wife. नहीं मैडम ने वो मैडम गाड़ी चला रही थी सो सी जंप्ड द लाइट, पुलिस वालों ने पकड़ लिया। उसने बोला अरे आपको मालूम नहीं आई एम द वाइफ ऑफ द पुलिस कमिश्नर। आई टोल्ड आई विल वेरी हैप्पी बाय सन वाइफ, माय वाइफ नेवर ड्राइव द व्हीकल। You will not believe, just 4 days back, one husband and wife, they came to meet me in my office. Might be around 55, 60 years of old couple. They were having some problem. First, this lady asked me, sir, you remember me? Manaka, no, I don't remember you. Immediately, she opened her purse and took out one paper, showed to me. There was a search, there was a letter signed by me in 1996. And she was keeping in her purse. I have given her character certificate. This is Mumbai. I have not seen anybody in Pune like this. I can tell you so many stories like this.
Okay, we're a little short on time, so we'll move. It's over. I'm so sorry, sir, but it's over.
Thank you very much. If you have anything, ask to ask.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. God bless you all.